Here we go. Good morning, Whitford Parish. I look forward to you joining me. In the meantime, I'm just going to read you a little bit about Trinity. Good morning, it's Trinity Sunday. So this is from No Ordinary Man, Book 2, by Nick Fawcett. And it's just his introduction to a Trinity service. We are here today on Trinity Sunday, a day which captures the imagination less than any other in the Christian year, and to a point that is understandable. For rather than historical events, this date in the calendar is concerned with abstract doctrine, which has perplexed theologians and ordinary believers alike across the centuries. Yet complex though the issues may be, we do well to reflect on them. For this should be a day which captures the imagination like no other, reminding us of the sheer breathtaking reality which we describe as God. We try to pin down that reality as best we can, to talk about our experience in terms of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But we are always at best simply grasping at the truth, for as the prophet Isaiah reminds us, God's ways are not our ways, neither are his thoughts our thoughts. Thank God for this day, which reminds us of this simple, inescapable fact, and use it to deepen your faith and enrich your experience of his living, loving, and transforming presence. So that was an introduction from No Ordinary Man, Book 2 by Nick Fawcett. And so I've got time to do a prayer out of my lovely book, When I Talk to You by Michael Lunig. Dear God, we give thanks for places of simplicity and peace. Let us find such a place within ourselves. We give thanks for places of refuge and beauty. Let us find such a place within ourselves. We give thanks for places of nature's truth and freedom, of joy, inspiration and renewal. Places where all creatures may find acceptance and belonging. Let us search for these places in the world, in ourselves, and in others. Let us restore them. Let us strengthen and protect them. And let us create them. May we mend this outer world according to the truth of our inner life, and may our souls be shaped and nourished by nature's eternal wisdom. Amen. Gorgeous little picture. Here we go. Here we are. Good morning to those who've joined me. Nice to see you. Thank you for being here on this Trinity Sunday. So you should have a Trinity order of service, and we're going to make a start with our service now. Everything's in the order of service. I decided to put all the hymns in as it's a one-off service for this year. So I hope you found everything that you need. Welcome, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and also with you. We're going to join together in singing our opening hymn. It's a Trinity hymn. We have to sing it. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Enjoy. turn back to our orders of service. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. How often have I longed to gather your children as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, says the Lord, but you would not come to me. Let us, as wayward children, return to our Father God and confess our sins. Father, you come to meet us when we return to you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you died on the cross for our sins. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit, you give us life and peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. So may the Father forgive you by the death of his Son and strengthen you to live in the power of the Spirit all your days. Amen. Let us give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and the wonders he does for his children. Let us offer him sacrifices of thanksgiving and tell of his acts with shouts of joy. So our collect for Trinity Sunday. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So let's join together in saying the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. We've got two readings this morning. Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 12 to 17, and then 27 to the end. So that's Isaiah chapter 40, verses 12 to 17, then 27 to the end. Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, or with the breadth of his hand marked off the heavens? Who has held the dust of the earth in a basket, or weighed the mountains on the scales and the hills in a balance? Who can fathom the spirit of the Lord, or instruct the Lord as his counsellor? Whom did the Lord consult to enlighten him, and who taught him the right way? Who was it that taught him knowledge, or showed him the path of understanding? Surely the nations are like a drop in a bucket. They are regarded as dust on the scales. He weighs the islands as though they were fine dust. Lebanon is not sufficient for altar fires, nor its animals enough for burnt offerings. Before him, all the nations are as nothing. They are regarded by him as worthless and less than nothing. Why do you complain, Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, my cause is disregarded by my God? Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And so there's a little acclamation before our gospel reading. Alleluia, alleluia. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. One God, who was and who is and who is to come, the Almighty. Alleluia. And so our gospel reading is from Matthew chapter 28, verses 16 to 20. So it's Matthew 28, verses 16 to 20, the Great Commission. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We're going to sing again, this time, "Father, we adore you, lay our lives before you, how we love you."
Lord, we adore you, lay our lives before you.
say the creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our prayers for this morning. I've mixed my prayers with some prayers from John Pritchard using the Intercessions Handbook. Let us pray together. Ever one, sacred three, holy God and Trinity. O God, beyond us, lead us forward to pray. O God, beside us, teach us gently to pray. O God, within us, still our hearts to pray. Holy God, beyond us, you create and sustain all things, but only by the power of self-giving love. We celebrate your creativity this morning, the rhinoceros and the dragonfly, the Himalayas and the spider's web. There is mystery and joy at the heart of creation. There is so much that we are thankful for. And so, Lord, we pray for your world, for the way we care for the planet, for the way that we recycle and use the natural resources that surround us. Help us to think about the future, for the generations to come, that they will be able to enjoy this amazing world in all its beauty. Amen. Son of God, beside us, you never leave us comfortless. Always you walk with us, neither too far ahead or a step behind. And you teach us the love songs of the kingdom. Lord, our minds are consumed with the tragedy in America of the violence and life lost of George Floyd. Lord, we pray for his family and his friends. We pray for our police force seeking to uphold the law in our country in a safe and fair way. And we pray for us all as we reflect on injustice, equality, acceptance, and the way that each one of us responds to difference. We thank you, Jesus, that you loved all people. Teach us to walk in your way. Holy Spirit within us, always you are seeking to infiltrate our lives with peace and strength. Always you are trying to give us more of yourself. Fill us with the warmth and courage of your life. We pray for those who are struggling against this virus. We pray for all families who have lost a loved one. We pray for all who are struggling this day with depression and isolation. Draw us into your presence and guide us in your ways. we pray for those known to us, particularly for Michael and Joan, for Beryl, for Don. And perhaps you can name out loud or in your heart those known to you. O God beyond us, give us faith. O Christ beside us, give us peace. O Spirit within us, give us life. Ever one, sacred three, Holy God, the Trinity. Amen. Today is a day of prayer for the new Bishop of Chelmsford. Do have a look at the diocesan webpage for more information. Do give them your points of view. What sort of a bishop would you like? We have the opportunity to respond. Hundreds have. So come on, it's your chance. But we're going to join our hearts to all in the diocese by praying the prayer that's been posted up. God of provision and care, discernment and knowledge, lead us in your love. Empower us by your Spirit. Equip us with your gifts. Give us hearts full of love for all people. Minds open to the signs of the times and wisdom to know how to respond to the voice of your calling. We ask this through him whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So as I say, it's a day of prayer, so do have a look on the diocesan website if you'd like to join in with any of that, or just take some time today, later today, just to stop and pray. What sort of bishop would we like to see in Chelmsford this time next year? Leading us all on, gathering the people of Chelmsford Diocese to following our Lord and Saviour. It's a great opportunity, so make the most of it. So the peace. I'm sad I can't pass the peace literally. You might have someone in your house you could pass the peace to. So do that, and if not, remember the people who you sit next to or that you sit around in church at this time. You can just think of them when we get to the end of the piece. Peace to you from God our Heavenly Father, peace from his Son Jesus Christ, who is our peace, peace from the Holy Spirit, the life giver, and peace of the triune God, be always with you and also with you. So we're going to just come together and join in this responsorial before we get to our spiritual communion today. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honour and power. For you have created all things, and by your will they have their being. You are worthy, O Lamb, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed us for God. From every tribe, language and nation, you have made us to be a kingdom and priests, serving our God. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honour and glory and might for ever and ever. Amen. Looking for the coming of his kingdom as our Saviour taught us, so we pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So we're going to join together in a time of spiritual communion, because we can't obviously join in communion together at this time. Almighty God, in union with the faithful at every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are being offered to the Father, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I present to you my soul and body with the earnest wish that I may ever be united to you. And since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all the affections of my soul. Let nothing ever separate me from you. Let me live and die in your love. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. 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 We're going to join together in singing again, this time, Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below.
Praise God.
joining me for worship this morning. It's good to see lots of you popping up on the screen. Do stay and see Andy, who'll be unpacking God's word for us this morning, straight after this, on the same area of Facebook. And then soon up at 11:30 will be Jess with her All Age. You might have heard this morning on the news that we are getting permission, probably, all things being equal, to open our churches for prayer. So we'll be working out a pattern as PCC members and finding out ways that we can safely open following our thorough risk assessment and I don't know what else. We'll get all the hand sanitizers in place so that people can pop in and out if they'd like to for prayer, which I'm sure people will be delighted to be able to do. We can pray anywhere. We're God's people anywhere, but we do love our church. Let's come to our blessing. And so I've got a cross here, so you can pack up all your bits and pieces and we can send them to the cross of Christ. So all our problems we send to the cross of Christ. All our difficulties we send to the cross of Christ. All the devil's works we send to the cross of Christ. And all our hopes we set on the risen Christ. And so the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for joining me. Join Andy and then Jess and have a lovely Sunday. We'll let you know. We'll keep you posted about when we can open the churches for prayer.